We begin with the BART police officer shooting case and victories and losses in court for both sides.
A judge makes several key rulings. Among the most critical, jurors will hear some details about the criminal history of the man who was killed. Former BART officer Johannes Meserle is facing murder charges for the death of an unarmed passenger, Oscar Grant. Because of all of the publicity here, the trial will be held in Los Angeles. And that's where ABC 7's Laura Anthony is reporting live tonight. Laura, as we said, several important decisions today.
Well, that's right, Dan. As part of the run-up to the trial, the judge here ruled on more than a dozen motions. Both sides won some and they lost some. But in the case of the defense, there were some clear victories.
A prior arrest of Oscar Grant can be used by the defense in the murder trial of former BART police officer Johannes Meserle. Meserle shot Grant in the back on a BART platform on New Year's Day 2009. Meserle claims he meant to pull his taser instead of his gun. A Los Angeles judge ruled Meserle's attorney can tell the jury about Grant's arrest in San Leandro in October 2006 and his attempts to run away. Police finally tasered Grant to get him to cooperate.
It was quite disturbing, if you will, evidence of his prior event of Oscar is going to come into evidence. It's certainly our view that event is more prejudicial than probative.
Judge Robert Perry also granted the defense motion to call a retired police officer as an expert witness to talk about the training officers get in firearms and tasers and how the two might be confused. It's testimony an Alameda County judge barred in the preliminary hearing. The Los Angeles judge will decide later if Meserle's attorney can call an expert to analyze the half dozen amateur videos taken of the incident.
We think that he should deny it in large measure because it would be offering someone else opinion about what they see or didn't see.
In other rulings, the judge excluded an alcohol breath test form Meserle signed the night of the shooting. Prosecutors claim Meserle checked a box on the form stating the shooting was not accidental. Grant's family was in court for this hearing and plans to attend all of the trial.
We believe that because of the demographics that we stand a chance to get a fair trial here in L.A. However, we do know, just based on history, that the law has been unfair to the common people when it comes to police officers.
Now, it's clear from today's motions that each side is doing everything they can to gain advantage at trial. The judge threw out many of those attempts. For instance, that form that Meserle signed the night of the shooting, the judge decided that was simply not relevant. Now, jury selection begins here in about 3 weeks, and Meserle's attorney indicated in court today that he has yet to decide whether his client will testify in his own defense. Live in Los Angeles, Laura Anthony, ABC 7 News.
All right, Laura, thank you.
And I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you, but I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land.
We're going to begin with breaking news.
This is an historic moment right here in the United States. Barack
Obama
has been elected the 44th president
of the United States
of America.
He is going to set all of the wrongs of the past right.
Oakland has more than its share of problems, so Phil Matier asked, what should
President Obama's top priority be right now?
There is a long history in this country of African Americans and Latinos being stopped by law enforcement disproportionately. And that's just a fact.
Our top story is a heated racial controversy out of
Oakland, California,
which is now getting national attention because President Obama has weighed in. As I was addicted to the
dark side, somewhere inside my childhood, when this gunshots overnight in Oakland, and one of those doing the shooting was a police officer.
A police shooting in Oakland is sparking outrage.
An Oakland police officer shoots and kills a man following a traffic stop.
Deadly officer-involved shooting overnight in Oakland.
Police are defending the shooting death
that ended in gunfire.
Police said the officer involved was defending himself against a man with a gun.
The driver did not have a weapon.
This is the second deadly police officer-involved shooting in Oakland this week.
Tonight, Oakland police are defending their fourth officer-involved shooting in 2 weeks.
This is the fifth officer involved shooting just the past month, the ninth for the city of Oakland all of this year.
We are getting an inside look tonight at what is driving Oakland's skyrocketing murder rate.
From witness and police accounts, this is what we've pieced together.
Oakland's gang units have carved up an 11 square mile region known as the Flatlands.
This is the battleground in the ongoing war. And as the year comes to a close, the violence shows no signs of stopping.
Racial violence in Oakland, that is the subject of this evening's Talking Points memo after a New Year's Eve fight on a train. A transit officer in Oakland shot a young man dead, and as he lay on the ground, reportedly incapacitated.
Look at this shit. We don't give a fuck. Hey, and the police, man, fuck you.
The shooting has led to violent demonstrations.
With Oakland police playing a cat and mouse game with the pockets of protesters zigzagging through downtown Oakland. This all started when a group of about 100 marchers smashed a police car in the intersection and tried to turn it over. That's when the riot gear came out and the protesters began setting cars on fire out there. We counted at least 5 cars on fire out there. It got so bad.
I got hit by a beanbag.
To live my life as an outlaw all along. Remain strong in this planet full of player haters. They conversate with death row full of demonstrators. And in the end, drinking Hennessy made all my enemies envy me. So cold when I flow, eliminating easily. Fall to their knees, they plead for their right to bleed. While begging me to keep the peace. What I can see, closer to achieve. In times of danger, don't freeze. Time to be a G. Follow my lead, I supply everything you need. And out to game and the training to make a G.
Do you know why I pulled you over?
No.
Step out of the car now.
No.
See my casket buried as a G while the whole world remembers me.
1-30, 1-30. 940B, officer down. 7400 block of McCarthy.
This is a citywide 940B. I need any available sergeant to respond and assist.
I need units to stand out. Spread out and look for these people.
It appears to be the greatest loss of life in the history of Bay Area law enforcement.
The tactical team is going to be going in, checking in the address, 2755 74th Avenue. I'd like radio silence. Sergeant Gonzalez will be leading the team.
Oh, fuck! Officer down,
officer
down. 940B. We have one officer down. We have a suspect down. Code 3 at the front door, copy?
3 police officers and a suspect are dead, and one officer is in grave condition following the pair of Saturday shootouts in Oakland, California.
With 4 officers killed in a single incident, the police death toll on this day is one of the highest ever in America.
An alert going out to all Oakland police officers. Be careful, especially before getting into your car.
The police believe that snipers have them in their sights in one Oakland neighborhood.
Someone in the crowd shot at police 7 times.
A suitcase-sized package was placed beneath an Oakland PD crime tech vehicle this morning.
The incident has threatened to raise tensions between the police and the Oakland community.
We're going to begin with breaking news. Oakland police involved in a standoff right now with a person they believe is armed. Playing out now at 74th and MacArthur in a building very familiar to Oakland cops.
On March 21st, 4 officers lost their lives by a gunman holed up in an apartment building. Well, it seems that another gunman has also holed himself up in that same apartment.
A new documentary depicts Oakland as a city held hostage by 10,000 gang members. If the claim of 10,000 gang members is true, that would mean that 2-3% of Oakland residents are in gangs. Oakland police say those numbers are inaccurate. The federal report suggests there may be 10,000 gang members in all of Alameda County, not just in Oakland.
This is sad, man. Hey, this is why Oakland needs to get militant, man. This right here, this is the reason why Oakland needs to get militant, man, for real.